the rest of the world. So in both ways, there is going to be a tremendous impact. And of course, the rest of the world also is facing severe problems, as we are well aware of what is happening in Europe, what is happening in the U.S. It is. But right now, China is one country which is recovering from the impact of the COVID-19 virus. So there has been an anticipation that probably production and things, the economy will get back to normal there much earlier than in the rest of the world.
There is still a dependence on China right now on the factory system to be able to produce and manufacture essential supplies, especially medical equipment. How important is China still to the global economy?
It still remains very important. I think we need to remember that even in the case of India, we have ordered several lakhs of antibody checking equipment, the testing equipment that is very urgently required in this country. And unfortunately, those orders have been delayed because there is demand from many other countries. Those orders are going to the US or to Europe, and Indian orders are not being fulfilled in yet. But China's production capacity obviously is not ramping up at the scale that people are anticipating. And yes, you are right that as far as medical equipment is concerned, that's an area that is not just in the whole world is looking forward to India, to China coming back to its normal production capacity levels.
So sure, we request that you please stay online as we are reconnecting with our other expert, Rajiv Nathwa. Rajiv, I hope you're still with us in Market Mantra.
Yeah.
Good to have you back on the program. Rajiv, what's your view on the stock market short term? We see a lot of build up in the futures market regarding some specific stocks. But more importantly, what is your reading of the market right now? What do you advise investors at this stage? Well, at home, but they can trade online.
Well, as you might remember, that it's going to remain volatile and the bias is going to be slightly towards the bearish side because, the flow of money to an asset class which is declining tends to decline, the flow of money tends to decline. And this time, because of the real overtaking emotion, the overriding emotion that the price tends to get pushed to the top, but that is a much faster higher, much better.